Hello, today I'd like to show you how to use the angel cutter. So you will need an angel set of cutters, a small pot of water, a non-stick rolling pin, a water brush and a small pot of white shortening. And I also use flour paste. I'm using the Renshaw's flour paste. I've coloured a small piece brown for the hair, and a small piece flesh, a small palette knife, a number 30 paintbrush, that's the fine brush for the eyes, a number 6 brush and a number 3, a little pot of isopropyl alcohol, magnolia pearl pink, a chocolate brown and a pearl white, and then a plain white that's going to be used for the eyes, and a small sponge pad for drying the pieces on. So I'm going to take a small piece of flesh-coloured flour paste and just work it so it's nice and pliable, and then rub a little of the white shortening onto the non-stick board and roll out the paste. Don't lift the paste up and down. You need to have a good contact with the board. And roll it thin. And then a little of the shortening onto the cutter. Place that down. Now just press around the outside edge of the cutter. And then a little more pressure over the face. Flick to remove it. And then peel the paste from around the outside edge. And put that back into your bag so it doesn't dry out. And then use a cocktail stick. There's just two little pieces here that you need to remove. So make sure you've removed them. And we're going to trim around the outside edge of this, because when we put the dress on top, it's easier if you have this base slightly shorter. So you take a knife, remove the flesh-coloured wing and down the side of the dress, just take a very small piece away, and again the opposite side, so remove the wing, a little of the sleeve and down and across the base, like so. Remove the wings and then place this onto a sponge pad, so just loosen it with a small knife and then lift and place that onto a sponge pad to dry. Just tidy up any little bits there. So my figure has fully dried. I left it on the pad overnight, and now I'm going to work a little of the pink colour into a brush, and I'm going to brush a little pink onto the cheeks. And then using the alcohol and a little white, the plain white colour, and the fine brush, I'm going to paint the eye. Like so. Just tidy that corner up a little. Now I'm only going to paint one so that I can show you the different ways of finishing the eye. I'm going to take brown and a little of the alcohol. And I always mix my colours in the lids so that when the alcohol has evaporated away, it goes back to a dust, so you don't waste any colour. And on this eye, I'm just going to paint a fine line, and that's going to be a closed eye. And on this eye, I'm going to paint the little pupil, and then just around the top edge so that she looks as though she's peeping to the right. And then on top of that brown pupil, it needs a tiny white dot, so you need a highlight, So again, a little of the alcohol and a tiny white dot in there. You may need to just thicken that up a little more so it's more noticeable. That's it. So I'm just going to cut out the hair. So I'll move my angel to one side and take some of the brown paste. Again, work so it's nice and pliable. A little of the shortening on the worktop, and then roll this small piece out. And then take the cutter and just put the shortening over the hair. Place onto the paste and press firmly around the outside edge and across the centre where the hair will be. Remove, pull that away, and then just use your cocktail stick again to pull, hold onto the paste as you pull that away. And bring my little angel back into shot, and then water. And around that top edge there. And then lift the hair and place that on top, following the embossed line where the fringe will be. And then coax the paste around the flesh part. You don't want to see a double layer there. The brown hair should be coming around that top edge. You can always use your knife just to tidy that up a little. Push that in and bring it back into a nice shape. Just press. I've rolled out a piece of white flower paste and I'm putting a little of the shortening onto the cutter. Press round the wings and down each side of the dress and across the base, and also across the base of the head. And then give a little flick. Remove the cutter and surplus paste. We don't need the head, so we can pull that away, but leave the wings attached. And I'm going to just take a cocktail stick to remove those two small pieces at the shoulders. And then I'm going to attach this onto the angel. So I'm using water. Over the dried figure. And make sure the water goes along that cut edge, and I'm going to lift the whole piece and drop it onto the dried angel. Now, because I've cut a little piece away from the flesh coloured frame, I can now easily press the dress around that edge, and that will cover the flesh part. Now we have white hands, so I'm going to cut out the hands and then the front of the sleeves to give it an extra layer into the foreground. So I'm going to move the angel to one side and just roll out a very small piece of the flesh, and I've got a little piece of white to one side. So again, shortening onto the nonstick board and roll out the paste, shortening over the hands and press firmly. And then use, I'm going to use a cocktail stick just to pull the paste from around the hands. It will look a little jagged because it's not designed as a cut line. So it will be slightly jagged, but you can tidy that up once it's in position. So bring the angel back. A little water. Lift the hands. Attached to my finger. And just press around the outside edge to make sure you have a nice contact there. And you can use your damp brush just to run around the edge, and that will also tidy up any little frayed pieces. So the hands are in position. So it's just this part now, the front of the sleeve, that I need to cut out. So again, a little more of the shortening. And a very small piece of the flour paste. Shortening over the cutter. Press firmly. And this time, you remove the inner part of the sleeve and everything else from around the outside edge. And the hand. So it's just this tiny little piece of sleeve that I need. So bring the angel back in. Moisten with water. Lift and place that on top. And then repeat for the other side. Away. And again, just moisten with water and place that into position. And again, with your damp brush, you can just tidy around any of the little edges there. Like so. And then I'm going to brush over that with white satin or a white shimmer. So just very carefully over the dress, just to give it a nice shine. And also over the wing. And she's ready to attach onto the cake.